Where's the ball? Huh? Where's the ball? Huh? Where's the ball? Here's the ball. Here's the ball, you dumb idiot dog. You dumb moron dog. Huh? Huh? You're an idiot. You are a moron. For people. Fire's for people. Not stupid idiot dogs.
Sometimes again.
I'm sorry, but listen. I heard some real interesting news from Bobby Feaster, as I said earlier. He found something sick and gross out in the old woods.
What?
A dead rat inside a half a basketball.
Walking, talking, Jesus!
That's right, fellas, and we're gonna go find it.
The woods?
Yeah.
Behind the school?
Yeah, what about it?
Are you crazy?
No.
That's old man Dinkle's land! If he catches us, he'll skin us alive! I don't think this is such a good idea, Jandy.
Listen, guys, we're always talking on and on about how we never get to see nothing sick or gross out in those old woods. I'd risk old man Dinkle's pitchfork for a chance to see the corpse of a dead rat any day. And inside a half a basketball? Inside a half a basketball? What do you say, guys?
Yeah, don't be such a chicken crap, Tommy.
Well, I'm in if Philly's in.
I'm in if Tommy's in.
And you know what I'm in? I'm Jandy, it's me.
We're in!
Atlantis Heights. Her towering skyscrapers. Her people. Her sickness. This used to be a people city. It was built that way. With houses to live in. Streets to drive down. And front lawns to enjoy. For people to enjoy, not for rabbits to enjoy, not for raccoons and dogs and mice and fish and squirrels to enjoy, and not for birds, for people. Spread your wings and fly, you beautiful bird! Who do you work for? Who do you work for? This is a people city. Who do you work for? Who do you work for? I feel pity for them. The citizens of this city. They're so cowed that they've come to accept things as they are. They have no dreams of a better future. One without bunny rabbits and birdie birdies. A better world. You and I have no business, boy. But the day I see you walk the streets without a leash is the day you lose everything. Understand? Good doggy.
Like Bruce Wayne.
I cannot escape who I am like, what I am like, not after what happened in 1995. I dream of that day, that night, that dark night. My parents and I had gone to People's Plaza to enjoy Michael Crichton's Congo on the silver screen. We were late, and the multiplex was confusing. Maybe we should have looked closer at our stubs, but we trusted the ticket taker when he said Theater 17. There was no Michael Crichton's Congo in Theater 17. There was only Batman Forever.
I like Batman. I like Batman. I'm like Batman.
It was dark that night, walking home from the theater. My mother was wearing the pearl necklace my father had given her for their anniversary. Then, in the shadows, we heard the squeak of a rat. My mother dashed into the street while my father tried to hold her back. Everything else comes in flashes. Blood and pearls on the street. Maybe a gunshot. Laughter. I don't know. Parents. Dead. Swore to myself. Something, something. Protector of the innocent. Animals are bad. I am. Like Batman. I'm pretty sure that happened. I can hear the city crying out. I say, I am your champion. But my voice is drowned out by the sound of grass being murdered. I see their little faces. The ones I put down. Jumper. Pidge. Dr. Hopalong. The Nibbler. The Easter Birdie. Cut Rabbit. Bat Rabbit. The Joker. There are others who resist.
Get all them stupid rabbits. Get them all! And then...
And then...
And then... Eat them all up. In a rabbit stew.
Don't you see, Commissioner? Then I'd be just like them.
Eat them all up!
No! Is it hopeless? They've infiltrated those closest to me.
She'll look at not just the leaf, but the underside of the leaf.
Oh, honey, make the face.
Oh, this is the face she makes all the time.
That looks just like your face, Mom.
Oh, I beg to differ.
Say hello to your sister. Pet your sister.
I have no sibling. I have no cat sibling.
Are you taking your pills?
Sometimes.
You're like,
Batman?
No. What? No, you're like being really weird.
Am I crazy for trying? Maybe I should just move to the moon, where there are no rabbits and dogs and geese. I think about that seriously sometimes. Moving to the moon. But then I remember Batman Forever. And how they killed my parents, I think. And I know that I'll stay. Am I crazy? No, I am like Batman.
Who do you work for? Who do you work for?
Thank you. It's another Friday night, and you're all alone. Angels, pick up the phone now, and you could be with any one of our specially selected angels. Angels. We've got innocent angels, naughty angels, barely legal angels, clown angels, accountant angels, cowabunga angels, Civil War angels, salad angels, communist angels, no angels. We've got strangels.
Angels!
So call now. It would be a sin not to.
Great work, everyone. I think this is gonna be a really sexy commercial. We can get them dressed and take those cans out of those bras.
Thanks. How did it look? I mean, did we look real? Do we look like real women?
It looked great. You look like fully developed women. Don't tell anyone this, but I had a little chubby going. It's not a joke. Those cans look like real female breasts. Well, great work. Your check should be in the mail in 2 weeks.
Oh, that was another job.
Yeah. Can't believe I just dressed up like a woman. Yeah. I guess a paycheck's a paycheck, right?
Oh, yeah. Ain't that the truth? You know, I can't believe people fall for this stuff.
Ooh, look at me. I'm a woman. I've got boobs.
I'm a woman. I've got boobs. La-dee-dee-da, I'm a woman.
Look, that box wine porno is as close as you and I are.
It better be. You butt baron!
You're a butt baron. Butt off.
Hey, you guys! Let's get the butt out of here!
Yeah, butt. Yeah.
Whoa! That was a close one.
Phew! I saw my whole life flash before my eyes. I was a doctor.
I was a fireman.
All I saw was darkness.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm getting pretty tired.
Yeah, maybe it's a good idea we take a journeyman's rest.
Oh, let's make a campfire.
If I got a lighter, my idiot dog took mine.
Tell us the story, Jandy.
Yeah, right, like you can handle my stories.
Try us!
You guys are gonna get to learn about Father Goose.
No.
Once upon a time, this guy, just a regular guy, goes to a grocery store. It's like any other grocery store you'd ever heard of.
If you go down in the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. If you go down in the woods today, you'd better go in disguise. For every bear that ever there was will gather there for certain, because today's the day the teddy bears have their pig.
Look who's awake. And you're gonna be big and strong for Daddy. Can you say Daddy? Say Dada. No? Look who wants to crawl away and leave Daddy. No. No crawling away. Because you're my little man.
Teddy bear who's been good is sure of a
Daddy
treat
loves
today.
You.
There's lots of...
Did you make a present for Daddy? Let's take a look. Yeah, open it. Oh, it's a surprise. Oh, you made a present for Daddy. My growing boy eats a big meal. Makes a big poopy. Alright. Let's get you all clean. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. Oh. Yes, we will. Yes, we will. And get you all clean. Mm-hmm. Feeling fresh. Yeah. Get you something you want. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. So, be your name Buxbaum or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai, Ali, Van Allen O'Shea, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. So get on your way. Enough for tonight. Every teddy bear who's been good is sure of a sweet day. Sleep well, my baby boy. Things to eat and wonderful games to play. Beneath the trees where nobody Daddy loves you. Hide and seek as long as they please. That's the way the teddy bears have their picnic. Picnic time for teddy bears. The little teddy bears are having a lovely time today. Watch them catch them everywhere. Daddy's gonna buy you a mockingbird. And if that mockingbird don't sing, Daddy's gonna buy you a diamond ring. And if that diamond ring turns brass, Daddy loves you.
If you go down in the woods today, you're sure of a big surprise. If you go down in the woods today...
Settle down. Guidance Counselor Richardson's going to say a few words.
I don't need to tell any of you how hard it is for me to stand here. This, the first day back after the tragic events that took place here last Thursday, November 10th. And after the memorial and all the funerals, enough words have been said, there's little I can add to ease your pain, our pain. None of us wish to relive that day. But it's a truth that I feel we have to face, and to that extent, we have created a detailed security plan that each of you will find before you in this assembly, and I believe my assistants, other administrators, have a copy of it on hand. The packet goes over changes in school security that we have implemented to help prevent and contain, God forbid, something like this happens again in the future. Also, all teachers, principals, administrators, and school faculty will wear a walkie-talkie like this one here at all times moving forward. Many of us... many of us know someone lost in the horrific, that unnameable horror that took place. But many of us also knew Chad Weiner. None of us could hope to know or understand what was going through his troubled head or heart that day when he decided to do what he did. And certainly, each of us feels an anger and a sadness inside of us, which certainly Chad felt. Let us be prisms, and let us take that anger and that sadness, and let's refract it and bend it, okay? And let's shape it into something like love and respect for our fellow man. The senior art class has designed these t-shirts, which are for sale. They are for sale in the cafeteria lobby. All proceeds go to the charity set up by the victims' families. And it's a very nice gesture. Lastly, let us all please rise while we remember the dearly departed. Tim Anger. Chris Combs. Warren Conley. Najma Karami. Andy Hill. Kate Jordan. Eva Chrisium. John Jandy Anderson. Christine Manga. Monica McMuir. Maureen Miller. Holland Reicher. I'm sorry, this is so hard. Max Uphaus. Colleen Vent. And Michael Vu. You will all be missed.
All I'm saying is we both saw that rabbit rotting in the tree hole. It would have been nice if we'd shared it.
I'm sorry, you want some?
I'm starving. Now I feel like a bitch.
We're both bitches.
Get back here. I had the strangest dream about Guidance Counselor Richards.
I think I saw some angels.
Yeah, well, you were just dreaming.
No, I think I really saw them.
You know what I think? I think you're a four-eyed pile of shit.
Pile of shit has 1,000 eyes.
You've always been full of bull hockey.
Huh?
You know what? I bet there isn't even a dead basketball inside half a rat anywhere.
It's half a rat.
I know what it is! You tell us these stories and drag us out to the woods where we can possibly die or get raped or be eat-raped? Why? So we'll think you're cool? Oh yeah, man, you're the bee's knees. But I've got news for you, Walter Cronkite. This is the pits! Billy and I are outie. Come on, Billy, let's go!
Stop it! I swear on Billy's stupid life, every word I ever told either one of you idiots is true. And if I heard Bobby right, then our treasure is just over here.
Now come on, Tommy, get it together. What else are we going to talk about when we're all grown up?
I realized in that moment that Jandy didn't just want this. He needed it. More than Billy or I could ever hope to understand. You see, some guys aspire to greatness. And some...
Tommy!
What?
Say something, man.
It seemed that the years of pretending to hear my adult self's voice had finally caught up with me.
Tommy!
What? Fine! I'm in if Billy's in. I'm in if Tommy's in.
And you know Jandy's in. Jandy's me!
I'm also in.
Let's go!
Let's go.
And this is my brother Clyde. We're Animal Control. It's all of that doing, this controlling animal did.
Look, if you let us go right now, we won't tell anyone.
No! You won't tell anyone. No one who enters the woods may leave. There is no going back.
No!
No!
That's so gross.
Do you not see? They would kill a dog who so much as bit his master's hand. Imagine what they might do to one who burned his master alive. As I did, I'm here now, with my children. And together we tootle each other in the cruel ways of your man. And I live as a god.
We've got atomic bombs!
Oh! We'll get the atomic bombs!
Don't do that!
I'm your god!
Bombs are for people! Sit! No!
Look.
Oh, God!
Oh.
Don't touch me!
Prometheus, I think that you're a smart dog and a good dog. And I know that, well, maybe things don't look great right now, but I think that we can work things out, dogs and people. Would you like a belly rub?
She asks me, Prometheus, god of dog and man alike, if I would like a belly rub.
Pretty funny.
Yeah, a little one. Yeah. Oh, yes.
Run, Georgia!
No!
Tickle, tickle!
We've got to do this now.
Always.
While we still can. You understand, don't you?
I've seen such horrors.
I can't do it.
Yes, you can.
No,
tell me.
I can't do
tell
it.
Tell me with your human wisdom.
I can!
Batman!
Like Batman, my old friend.
I told you you'd be filthy rodent. Try to play with fire, and I'll eat your liver for all eternity.
And I told you then, I don't understand what that means.
Greek mythology for people!
Species, and yet peerless within our own species, except, of course, in your case for actual battle.
The only thing I know is that every dog has its day. It's death day. Happy death day, Prometheus! So this is what happens when an unstoppable force
Prometheus, you're alive.
You, a she-human, have saved me.
Maybe you were meant to live.
Yes. Maybe I was. Indeed. Who knows what strange adventures lie ahead for Prometheus, god of dogs and king of men.
what happened.
No! Don't breathe, yes! No! Oh, God!
A goon! A goon! Ha! I got that son of a bitch running through my trash piles, upsetting my precious treasures. Don't worry, ma'am. You and your dogs are safe. I saved you. I'm a hero! I'm a hero!